Hi everyone, Anthony Morganti here. Today I'm going to share with you my favorite Lightroom Classic keyboard shortcuts. In the video, you're going to often hear me use the word command. That is because I'm using a Mac, and a Mac keyboard has a command key. If you're using a PC, you won't have a command key, but will instead have a control key. So whenever I say command, equate that to control on your PC keyboard. Also, I'll be using the word option because on a Mac keyboard, there is an option key. A PC doesn't have an option key, but instead has an alt key. So if you're using a PC, whenever I say option, equate that to alt. So option equals alt, command equals control. In the description below this video, I have a list of all the keyboard shortcuts that I mention in this video, and I'll have them divided by PC and Mac, so you could easily copy and paste them. All right, let's get started. Whenever I need to import images into Lightroom, I use the keyboard shortcut Shift-Command-I. When I do that, no matter what module I'm in, it will jump me over to the library module and open up the import dialog. I prefer to do it that way because my typical Lightroom workflow means that when I end a Lightroom session, I'm not in the library module when I reopen Lightroom, because often I go out, take photos, I come back, and I'll open Lightroom to import them. If I was in the library module, there is an import button over here, but the other modules don't have that import button. The way my workflow works, usually I end my session, I'm in the develop module because I just processed an image, or I'm in the print module because I just printed an image, then I close down Lightroom, I go out and take photos, I come back home, I'm ready to import them, I open up Lightroom, I'm in either the develop or print module, I'll just hit Shift-Command-I. Automatically jumps me over to library module, opens up the import dialog, and I could easily import those images. Then it keeps me in the library module so I could cull those images. Now, to export an image, of course, in the library module, I have an export button. But I'm often, when I'm ready to export, I'm in the develop module. There's no export button there. Now, I could go up to the file system, go up to file, and I could import from there, export from there. But it's easier when I want to export, hit Shift-Command-E. And it brings up the export dialog, and I'm ready to export. And I could do that from any module. When I want to send an image or images into Photoshop, what I'll do is I'll select them in the film strip. I could select more than one by holding in the Command key on my Mac and just clicking on the ones I want to open in Photoshop. Then I just hit Command-E. It doesn't warn you. It doesn't give you any dialog or anything like that. It just will open those images directly into Photoshop. If you had more than one image selected in the film strip in Lightroom, it will open each of those images in Photoshop in individual tabs. In this case, I only had the single image selected, so it opened that single image into Photoshop. Now, another thing I like to do is manipulate the panels in Lightroom. Lightroom has four panels, top, bottom, left, right. Often, I want some of those closed. The function keys control those. The F5 key gets rid of the top panel. Hit it again and it will come back. F6 gets rid of the film strip at the bottom. Hit it again and it will bring it back. F7, the left panel. And F8, the right panel. When I'm in the develop module processing an image, I usually don't need the film strip. So I'll hit the F6 key to get rid of that. And I don't like the left panel, so I'll hit the F7 key to get rid of the left panel. And that's the way I like to work in the develop module. Now, of course, if I wanted to bring those back, just hit those function keys again, and you could bring those back. Sometimes I like to get rid of all the panels at the same time. To do that, hold in the Shift key and tap the Tab key, and you'll get rid of them all. Bring them back by holding in that Shift key and hitting the Tab key again. So that's another keyboard shortcut that I often use. Now, often there's information over here on the left side of the image, and it gets in my way, especially when I'm in the develop module and I'm processing an image. I don't like to see it there. You could see it's not there now. But if I need to see some information, the resolution of the image or the exposure info or maybe what lens I used and what focal length I shot at, I hit the I key. I hit the I key once, It shows me the date it was taken and the resolution of the image, plus the image name. I hit the I key again. It will give me the exposure info as well as the lens info and the focal length I shot at. Hit the I key again, and it gets rid of that. So that's, you know, I often am hitting that I key. Now, actually, because it bothers me to be in the develop module with the film strip there, I'm going to get rid of that. And I'm going to also get rid of the left panel as well. So that's the way I like to work in the develop module. Now, let's talk about before afters. I think most people use this keyboard shortcut if it's on your keyboard. Some European keyboards and Asian keyboards don't have this key. It's the backslash key. Tap it once and you'll get a before. That's before you did any work on it. Tap it again and you'll get your after. Now that key has kind of dual functionality. As I mentioned, you could tap it to see a before, tap it again to see the after, or if you hold it in, you'll see a before. Then when you let go, you'll see the after. So you could change the functionality slightly. I usually just tap it to see a before and tap it again to see an after. Also, every now and then, I'll use the before after that is a side-by-side view. To see that, hit the Y key on your keyboard and you'll see a before on the left, the after on the right. Hit the Y key again to get back to the single image to work on. Now, sometimes you may not want that side-by-side view like that was. If you want a different before-after, but it's still a side-by-side view, hold in the Shift key and hit the Y key. And then you'll get this split-screen view. Unfortunately, this isn't a line that you could slide back and forth, like in some apps. It just gives you the before on the left, the before on the right. Now, if you hit the Y key again, you'll go back to your normal view and you could work on the image. But now, because you hit Shift-Y once, if I hit the Y key all by itself, I'll get the same view again. If you want to get out of this, you don't want to have this to be the default view when you hit the Y key, hit the Y key so you're in it, then hold the Shift key in and hit the Y key so you're here, then hit the Y key. Now, that will be your default view. Now, if you prefer to have an over-under view, hold the Option key in and hit that Y key and you'll get that over-under view. Hold the Option key in again to go back to that view, and it doesn't default to that. Actually, you don't have to hold the Option key in to get out of this. You could just hit the Y key. You'll go to here, then hit the Y key again, and you'll be there. So you could kind of toggle through different views. But I don't use those Y keys as often. I prefer that backslash key, just like that. Now, to jump from library module to develop module, I often use just keyboard shortcuts. If I want to just get into the library module and look at the single image, I hit the E key on my keyboard. It will bring me the library module, and I still have that single image. I want to jump back to the develop module, hit the D key, D for develop, and I'll jump back over there. Now, if I want to jump to the library module, but I want to see the images in grid view, hit the G key on your keyboard, and you'll jump to the library module. Jump back to the develop module, hit the D key. Now, I'm going to give you a couple keyboard shortcuts that I often use for tools. First of all, cropping the image. I hit the R key on my keyboard to open up the crop tool. You can see that I straightened it. Let me reset that. Because often what I'll do when I want to straighten an image, I'll hit the R key on the keyboard to open up the crop tool. Then I want to use this angle tool. So instead of clicking on it so that the cursor turns into the angle tool, draw my line, then putting the tool away by clicking on that little circle, what I'll do is I'll hold the Command key in and on my Mac. It will temporarily turn the cursor into the angle tool or the angle tool. So I'll just straighten it that way. So to give you a breakdown, what I'll do, and this is so easy, I hit the R key, I hold the Command key in, I then draw my straight line with the Command key held in, let go, and there it is. And then I hit the R key again to close down the crop tool. That is one keyboard shortcut I always use. Another one is when I use a radial filter, sometimes is those of you that watch my videos know that often I'll go to the effects module and I'll put a slight vignette on the image. You can see this image has a slight vignette and we have some controls for that vignette. But sometimes there's things I want to do that the vignette tool isn't capable of doing. So in those instances, I'll use a radial filter tool. To get to the radial filter tool, I'll just hit Shift M, and that opens up the radial filter tool. If, by the way, if you wanted to open up the graduated filter tool instead, don't hold the shift key and just hit the M key and you'll open up the graduated filter. So M for graduated filter, shift M for radial filter. Now the radial filter tool, when it's open, what I want to do is put a oval on here, a radial filter on here that just goes from one edge to the other edge on the left, right, top, and bottom. So to do that, what you need to do is draw a radial filter on here. It could be anywhere and it could be any shape. So just draw a radial filter on here. It could be like any shape and it could be any place on the image. Then to get it to go edge to edge, hold the command key in and double click on the little pin in the middle. And when you do that, it will just expand out and touch every edge. Then I could do other things that the actual vignette sliders don't or just aren't capable of. For example, I could come in and I could take sharpness all the way down. I could take texture down and clarity down and kind of blur out those edges. And then maybe I want to make them a little darker as well. Maybe I want to go to saturation and take that down a little bit. So I could do a lot of things with the radial filter that I can't do with a normal vignette tool. And often I do that. So the sequence of events here is I would hold the shift key and hit the M key to open the radial filter tool. I'll draw a tool on here. Then I'll hold in the command key and double click on the pin in the middle so that it expands. And then I'll move the sliders as I need to affect that tool. So that is a keyboard shortcut sequence that I'm often using when I'm using the radial tool. And again, whenever I need to use the graduated filter tool, I'll just hit the M key. And finally, I'm just going to leave this with you. If there's ever a keyboard shortcut or you think that something you use often might have a keyboard shortcut, what you could do is if you notice I'm hovering over the graduated filter and it's showing graduated filter and then in parentheses M, that means the M key is the keyboard shortcut. The keyboard shortcut for the brush tool, for example, is the K key. The keyboard shortcut for red eye correction, well, there isn't one. I didn't even know that. Spot removal, Q. I'm often doing that as well. I'll just hit the Q key for the spot removal tool. Also, if you go up to the menu system and you look at things, for example, export, Shift-Command-E. Export with previous settings on my Mac, that is Option-Shift-Command-E, and so on. So you can see there's keyboard shortcuts listed next to the commands that are in the menu system. So you could just look up there and see what the command is and then make note of it, and then you'll be able to access that function with keyboard shortcuts instead of having to go up to the menu system. So those are keyboard shortcuts in Lightroom Classic that I use every single time I use Lightroom. And I hope that helps you better utilize Lightroom and make it work better for you. Thank you, everyone who watches my videos. I really do appreciate it. I'll talk to you guys soon.